Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to invite all of you here to this August gathering to celebrate FINO's fantastic success in catalyzing the financial inclusion revolution in the country and basically bringing banking and financial services quite literally to the doorstep of the man on the street.
All of you to this very important day for us as FINO, a celebration for us having crossed 1.5 crore customers or 15 million as a customer base. Now, scale in a country like India is very, very important. The estimated number of people who don't have these services is 400 million. And unless a model is able to achieve scale and deliver to a very large number of customers, it really does not serve the purpose. And that was one key thing for us which we wanted to deliver. We achieved our first million in 365 days. We did the second million in 180 days. And we have been doing it faster and faster. In fact, we crossed the 10 million mark on 27 January 2010, that this year. And in 4.5 months, we have added another 5 million customers to this number. And today we stand at 15 million customer base. Now, to put this number in perspective, there are some 60 million below poverty line households in the country. And the two large schemes for which we work, the Rashtriya Swasthya Bima Yojana and the Mahatma Gandhi NREGA or National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme, both of them are focused on households. In fact, in RSBY, we only count one customer as one household. We don't even count them as multiple members whom we enroll under the scheme. So from that perspective, if you see, we have already covered 25% of the BPL households in the country, only in a month. So the time would not be far when we would have covered the entire below poverty line customers ourselves as FINO.
Great pleasure for me to be here. I cannot tell you how pleased and proud I am of the work that FINO has done over the years. It has not been an easy journey for the FINO team. Many changes in business models, many changes in the direction that had to be taken. But really, the determination of the team, and I must say the support of strong backers like Mr. Nair, like Dr. Chakrabarty, investors like IFC, and others that are in the audience, was quite important to actually get this overall effort off the ground. And as Manish was pointing out, the attraction and the appeal of this way of doing financial inclusion, the earlier belief was that you had to dilute security, you had to dilute standards in order to serve very poor people, that it was not possible to go out and build financial services or delivery capability because using the same standards as we would in urban India, because there was no choice but to do it using weaker frameworks, and we have seen many consequences of that overall thinking that unfortunately has played out over the last 40-50 years. What has happened now is that technologies have converged in a way, both on the financial services side as well as on the ICT side. And regulation has now joined hands over the last 4 or 5 years, as Manish was pointing out, that the whole framework is in place. That you can now say, I will do both. I will have high quality as well as remote access. And they started with a variety of products. I'm very enthusiastic about the new work they're doing with Union Bank in the remittances frame, for example, moving money for the first time in a secure manner from the slums of Bombay to remote rural geographies, making sure that people get money at extremely low costs when they need to. And the whole authentication technology that they have pioneered the usage of, I'm pleased to see now the government itself has said that they will move the entire country using the unique identity effort broadly in the direction of using biometrics like fingerprints to make it a stable part of the way a citizen is identified.
When the Honorable Finance Minister articulated the point of inclusive growth, it had within it a component of extending banking facilities to 50% of the population of the country. In nook and corners of the country, in urban I think centers like Dharavi, where large number of populations not yet introduced to the banking facility. But that dream is possible only when we have something to deliver. And today, when we celebrate 15 million customers to be reached out, I think we are clearly on our way to make this great vision of Honorable Finance Minister possible. So let us celebrate that possibility of inclusive growth in the country. Let's also celebrate for one more reason, coming of age of a business correspondent as a model. I think when business correspondent as a model was first propagated by Reserve Bank of India, all of us were not yet clear how do we go about doing it. And today, I think Fino's success should clearly articulate a point that business correspondent as a model is possible. Bankers can depend on BCs, and we can work towards achieving financial inclusion. When we read about financial inclusion across the globe, it by and large boils down to remittances. And many players discuss about it as product of remittance. But then when Dr. Rangarajan committee gave the clear definition of financial inclusion, it is not just remittance. It had many more components. In Indian situation, it has to be facilitating savings, credit, remittance, insurance, and whole lot of products. But just in 2 to 2.5 years, the Fino has done a commendable job of innovating on every one of these products. Let me congratulate on innovations in financial inclusion.
Time to celebrate, yes, we must celebrate. To bring the banking facility to 15 million people, it is a great achievement during time frame. But then we should not be complacent. Every bank has agreed that they believe in this business and they believe in this particular model, ICT-based financial inclusion. Every bank has a 3-year plan, and there is no compulsion on the bank, only we discuss the plan, how it is to be achieved. And we are very clear, if you say banking service, we have made it very clear, it is not that somebody from a remote place 20 kilometers away has come to an urban town and opened an account and you say I am providing banking service to that village. When we are saying banking service, either a brick and mortar branch or a BC must be available, Fino representative must be available in that village, the service has to be made available. When we are saying banking service, we have said that it is not covered as banking service unless 4 products are, minimum 4 banking products are available. That is a saving bank cum overdraft. Second, a pure saving product. Ideally, a recurring deposit or variable recurring deposit scheme. Third, is a remittance product. We are saying that they are developing. And fourth, is an entrepreneurship credit product, either a GCC and KCC. And because it is a BC-led model, this must be seamlessly integrated. All this year, handhold device or front-end device must support this 4 type of product, and they must be seamlessly integrated with the back-end, and for that, whatever technology modification necessary, banks have agreed to do that, and I think Fino has established the technology, and that is the right time to celebrate, and then globally it is being recognized. So I congratulate, and I feel that this particular celebration will also lay the foundation to bring the real financial inclusion in the society, and I hope that we'll be celebrating much more such occasions in the coming days, not only in India, but globally Fino will be a recognized company for bringing the financial inclusion to the underprivileged people in this society.